point gap with HVDC. The main aim of this experiment is to plot the breakdown characteristics using plain point gap. You can have a look at the apparatus, and one by one you can see the steps of the procedure, how to do. You can have a glance of the procedure one by one. Now let us see the main heart of this experiment is circuit diagram. In the circuit diagram, I have a single phase auto transformer connected to a HV transformer. It is step up transformer. You can see the input is 230, output is 50 kilovolts 5 kVA transformer, connected to a rectifier, 70 kilovolts DC rectifier. The output of this rectifier is 70 kilovolts, and this is given to a point, plane and a point, by means of a water resistor and RC filter and resistance divider. RC filters, it filters the unwanted harmonics in the supply given to your resistance divider. It divides the voltage which is needed to run this to break down this dielectric medium, and in between this plane and point, the dielectric medium which is used is air. All these ends are grounded. All the ends are grounded. Now let us have a look at the components of all this circuit diagram. A high voltage transformer. You can see the nameplate details of the transformer. Input is 230 volts. Output is 70 kilovolts DC transformer. The output of the transformer. Output of the transformer is connected by this coaxial cable to a rectifier. You can see at the bottom, you have a 70 kilovolt high voltage rectifier. You are having a 70 kilovolt high voltage rectifier shown here. And this rectifier is connected through a cable to a 70 kilovolts high voltage filter. You can see the filter, 70 kilovolts high voltage filter. And this filter is used to remove unwanted harmonics. It is joined to a 70 kilovolts high voltage divider. This divider is used to take the amount of voltage which is needed to break the dielectric medium. And this high voltage divider is connected to a water column resistor. This is called as a water column resistor. It is used to avoid pitting. So this is connected to a plane with a point. Now let us see the vernier caliper, how to vary the distance between these two. Initially the vernier caliper should be rated at 0 volts. Now by rotating this, I am bringing it to 12 volts. You can see here to 12 mm. So vary this vernier caliper and observe 12 mm. You can see the readings. When varying, you can see it reached to almost 10. Slowly vary it. Reach to. It has reached to 12 mm. Now see the gap. The gap between the plane and the point is 12 mm. So in between this 12 mm, the dielectric medium enclosed is air. Now by this experiment, we have to find out the breakdown strength of the air with 12 mm distance. So let us see the conduction part. Your mains is on. Initially when the door switch is closed, your mains is off indicates. Now mains on. HT high tension on. You can see the unit is ready before. Now it has lost its glow. Now reset when needed, you have to reset it. If the door is open, it will indicate. If the dielectric medium is failed, if it is tested, it will indicate sample failed. And memory can't be used for DC. It is only for AC. Now observe your variable input voltage. I am varying my variable input voltage. Here is my variable input voltage. By varying the auto transformer, I am observing the variable input voltage. So observe, see the effect, see the spark between your plane and point. It's nothing but a corona effect you will be observing. A spark with a glow and with a hissing sound. You can feel the sound now. A sound has started. Observe the spark. So your voltage, DC voltage, almost reached to 20 kilovolts. It reached to 20 kilovolts. So at 25 kilovolts, you have observed the spark. Your DC charging voltage has reached almost to 25 kilovolts. Your sample have failed, means the sample have been tested. So if I want to go back, I have to reset. I have to bring my auto transformer back to zero. Then your unit is again ready. So I have to do this sample of testing recursively for 3 or 4 times so that I can find out my flashover probability with accuracy. So I'll be doing it once again. Just observe it once again. Your mains is off. Now switch on the mains again. You can see the unit is ready. The dielectric medium is ready for conduction. HD is on. Now slowly vary this variac. At one point you will be observing a spark in the kit. You can see the spark in the kit. Go on varying it. You can observe the DC charging. It has went back from 24 to 0. And you have observed the spark in the before iterations. Same thing can be proceeded for 4 or 5 times. See, again I have brought my auto transformer back to 0. Your unit is ready. I have reset. Same experiment can be conducted 4 to 5 times. So that the flashover of the probability is taken, the average of all these iterations. This is about the conduction part. Now one main important precaution is there before starting the calculation part. Let us see the main important precaution. This is the discharge plot, which is very, very important for the precautions to be taken. When the experiment is conducted, charges will be flowing through this line, so that charges should be discharged to the ground. That is done through a human body. When a human body touches this glass is an insulator. The charges flow through the human body to the ground, so that the charges are discharged to the ground. So that all the ends of this lines should be discharged. This is a very, very important precautions which have to be followed after the conduction of the experiment. Now let us have a look at the tabular column with all the readings and the model graph. Pressure should be recorded by a barometer. Aneroid barometer is used to record the room pressure, and a thermometer is used to record the temperature. You can see the temperature and the pressure by means of these two equipment. Record the room temperature and pressure, and that will be incorporated in the tabular column. So now let us have a look at the tabular column. So the barometric pressure today is 730 mm of mercury. The room temperature is 18 degrees centigrade. We have performed the experiment at 12 mm. At 12 mm, my voltage is 16 kilovolts. I have done 3 times the flashover, 16, 16, 16. Similarly, I can conduct this for 6, 8, 10, 14. Same experiment is repeated for all the 3 value, and the mean is taken. Here RMS value is not taken since it is DC. If it is for AC calculations of voltage, you have to take RMS. Now let us see the model graph of this experiment. In the model graph of this experiment, you have to plot the x-axis with the gap mm and you have to plot the y-axis with the v-mean. Take the gap mm versus v-mean. You will be observing a straight increased line. So the main aim of this experiment has been proved. The breakdown characteristics of air as a medium has been predicted with the different distances and compared at different values.